Hey, this is Peter. In today's video, I would like to show you the responsive options Smart Slider offers in the slide editor. Let's start off by understanding what responsive means in web design. Responsiveness is when your layout looks good on any desktop, tablet, or mobile device. Simply scaling down the slide is not a solution as you won't be able to see the content properly. Keeping the desktop view isn't a good idea either as it won't look nice. So to have a proper look on small screens, it's inevitable to change the layout. Go to the slide editor to see what options could help you to achieve this. Within the layer window, the little device icons are showing the options, which can be edited device specifically. On the device selector, you can see the currently edited device or switch to a different view. Let's switch to tablet view. The layout is fine here, but the texts are too big. At each text layer, you can find a font resizer if you click on the text icon, when you're not in desktop view. With its help, we can make the font smaller for the current device. It looks much better now. We can move on to the mobile view. If you have multiple columns in one row, but they don't have enough space, select the row. Use the Wrap After option to break the columns to more lines. If you don't like the column order, drag and drop them into their correct places. There could be layers what you don't want to display on mobiles. Simply click on the eye icon to hide them from the currently edited view. Later on, you can always find them on the layer list. Inside the right-click menu, there will be a Hide On option to select where the layer should be hidden. We already learned how to make this text smaller, and it's time to do that now. When you adjust your layout for mobile, you should aim to have around 500 pixel tall slides, which will look nice on mobile phones. The padding values are device specific too. So let's adjust them for this mobile view. The margins can be changed similarly. Now my mobile slide looks great, but we should also think about landscape view. With the resizer, you can take a look at how the slide would look on wider mobile screens. My content is a little bit wide, so I'm going to use the maximum width to make it narrower. These are the options you need to know to create responsive slides. Let's take a look at some common mistakes. In a slider, all slides can only have the same height. This height is based on the tallest slide. If you have a slide which is too tall on mobiles, then a notice appears to warn you about it. With many layers, the options you have is to simply hide some of the content. This will decrease the height of the slide because it is given by the layers, margins, and paddings used on it. If hiding layers isn't an option for you, you can also just hide the entire slide. The default responsive behavior of the slide is that as you make the screen smaller, the slide will go smaller with the given slider size ratio. If you only have a few layers, or you don't have layers at all, they won't increase the height. In these cases, you can use paddings to increase the height of the slider. If you try absolute positioning, it might seem like a great way of adding layers, as you can just simply drag and drop them wherever you want. But if you take a look at mobile view, you will soon realize that this is going to be a responsive nightmare. For this reason, you should only use absolute layers for decoration. To create the main content of your slide, always use default layers. Default layers need way fewer adjustments for the perfect responsive display. This is all about responsive slide editing. I hope you enjoyed watching the video. If you did, please leave a like, and if you want to see other videos like this in the future, subscribe.